Hello and welcome back to my time zone converter series. This is the final part in my series where I'll be combining all the elements from the previous three parts together. I'll be taking the flow that I created in part one, the app I created in part two, and I'll be talking about how you combine those two with common data service from part three, all together to finish the app out. Just as a reminder, the objectives for this app were to take Flow's convert time zone action, which we did in part one, to use PowerApps to collect the date and time, the source time zone, and the destination time zone, which we started doing in part two, and then to use the common data service to get a list of time zones, which we did in part three. And finally, in part four today, we're going to talk about how to connect Flow and CDS and PowerApps together to finish the app. So this is the finished app. This is where we're headed. Up here, we've got the date and time pickers. Then we have the source time zone dropdown combo box. And you can pick something from here. Let's say my time zone, Eastern. And then the destination time zone, we'll say, we'll go UTC. And then convert time will actually trigger the flow. And you'll see the output here. All right, so now let's get on to the finishing touches. So this is where I left off with the app. We have a time zone converter app that's not quite done yet, but we do have a date picker. We have the hour dropdown. We have the minute dropdown. We have a source time zone, which is populated with data from common data service, and specifically the time zone definitions. And same data source for the destination time zone. And the only other thing that I've done that's worth noting is I created a reset button, which resets these five controls to their default state. Other than that, though, I haven't done much else. So what we need to do now is finish the app. So I'm going to go ahead and connect the flow by going to Action, Flows, and I'm going to go ahead and click Time Zone Converter. Close that out. So you'll see up here the flow is asking for three parameters: the time, the source time zone, and the destination time zone. One of the problems we have, though, is that these three controls here that make up the date and time have to be combined before they can be sent onto the flow. So how do we do that? Well, we start off with the date picker. We get the selected date. Next, we need to get the time. There's a time function that takes the hour, minute, second, and millisecond. And we're going to go ahead and get the value of the dropdown. And then we're going to do the value of the minute dropdown. Dot selected value. And then zero, and then zero, like so. And then for some reason, we have an error message. What's going on? Oh, it looks like I missed the parentheses. Oh, it's because I'm not done yet. Now I need the source time zone. Selected, not selected items, selected. And I'm going to do standard name, then the destination. And again, we're going to go standard name. And I don't see any error messages. That's good. However, I need to get back something from Flow. So right now I'm sending things to Flow, but I need to get back my response. There's a couple ways you can do that. One way is to use a variable. So if I do this, select Eastern time, click convert. So how do I know it worked or didn't work? Well, I'm not seeing the response here because I didn't add anything. So what I need to do is go to variables and look at response and see there, I see my response. We have to deal with that. That doesn't look like what I want to display, but let's talk a little bit about the fact that it comes back as a record. So another option besides set is you can also do a clear collect. Just change this to another time. I'll come down here to collections, and there's my response. It's really dealer's preference on this one. I'm not going to say which way is better or not. To see the results, though, I need to add some sort of display to look at it. You could use a label. I could come in here and just add a label. And I could do response dot time, but that's not going to work because I'm using a collection. So what I need to do is say I only want the first response, and then I see the result. Another option is to use a text input field. Why would you choose one or the other? Again, in this situation, I'm not using a text input field for inputs. So there's no real reason to use a text input field, except for perhaps aesthetics. And also, when I'm using my reset function here, I can actually use the reset function to reset a text input field. But I can't use it to reset a label. So if I tried to reset a label, it'll give me an error message saying I can't do that. So that's one of the reasons why I sometimes will use a text input over a label if I'm trying to reset the screen. I can, however, use this label for my error. And then let's go ahead and put another text input in. And this one, I want it to display the time that is currently selected up here. I can do that by using the same formula I used when I was sending the function here. So I could just come over here and just copy that and paste it. But I don't like the way it's formatted, so how do I fix that? Well, that's where text comes in. I'm going to format it with the text function. Now I see it like that. I'm going to make this larger so that it's more legible. All right. So this is now displaying roughly what I wanted to see. It's showing me the date and then the time in military time. This one, though, however, is not showing me what I want. So I need to fix that. To do that, I need to go into the... Well, I could do it here, perhaps, using a text function. But remember that the flow actually has a format string built into the function. So rather than doing it in PowerApps, I'm going to do it in Flow. So here we are in Flow, and you'll see under the convert function here, it defaults to sortable date time pattern. If you see what you want here in the pre-populated list, by all means, pick it. I don't see what I want, so I'm going to do a custom value. I'm going to do month, day, year, capital HHMM. And I'm going to save it. It's always good to do a test. You can use previous data to run your test. And there's what it looks like. So let's go back to the app. And if I run this again, now it's formatted the way I want it to be formatted. However, you'll notice when I click reset, it doesn't reset these two inputs, so I need to fix that. I'm going to go up here. I'm going to reset. Let's see if that fixes it. Nope. Okay, so why is that? Well, that's because the default value is this. And when you hit reset, it resets it to the default value. So that's correct, technically. Because I'm using value, value is converting this blank into zero. And then that's displaying here. And as for this, this is displaying the response, the first response, and that is still here. So the reset button is not done yet. You need to actually add a clear function. So that clears out the response. And then for here, I don't want to display this if this is blank and this is blank. Or to put it another way, if these two are not blank, then show this. So we'll do an if statement. And I'm going to use an and function. And I'm going to do not is blank. And not is blank. And copy this. All right. Do I have too many parentheses or too little? Okay, there we go. So it just takes a minute to figure it out, but eventually you'll get it right. Now I see nothing. And if I pick hours, now it's showing me what I just picked. If I pick nothing, it shows me nothing. Okay. So far, so good. There's still one thing that I don't like, which is that this convert button is still showing me active even when this is not all filled out. So it's not good to allow users to submit data that is incomplete. So if you're doing a form or you're doing a flow, it's always great to limit the user's ability to start a flow or to submit a form until they've filled out all the required fields. There's a lot of ways you can do that, but I'm going to show you my way, which is using the display mode. So by default, it's an edit mode, and I'm going to change that. So if and we need these four fields, date is always going to have a value. We need these four fields to not be empty. So if not blank, hour, drop down, selected. Is blank. Minute drop down. Selected. Not is blank. And we're going to do source combo box dot selected. Finally, not is blank destination dot selected. And if all that is right, display mode dot edit. Oops, I'm writing wrong. Display mode dot edit, and if not, display mode dot disabled. Oh, I missed something here. Is blank. Oh. There we go. Okay. All right. So if I reset it, it's disabled. If I fill out all the required fields, it's enabled. Oh, I got an error message. Always good to change your error messages to red so people know that they're error messages. You can also add a label. There's my error message. I'm gonna move that up a little bit. Change that to top. Make that auto height. There you go. So there, it's displaying UTC now. And you can see the format's kind of weird. I might want to change that. And you can do that in Flow. Or you can do that here. But it's probably better to do in Flow. So we could go to Flow and do that if you'd like. So when it fails, I'm sending it UTC now. But instead of doing that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use, instead of UTC now, I'm going to use a function format date time. And then I'm going to use UTC now. And then I'm going to use my own custom format that I used for the other one up here. You could also copy and paste this, I suppose. But I'm just going to type it out. Unfailed. Oh no. So I need to test this from inside PowerApps to get the error message out. And there it is. So that's it in a nutshell. Here are some additional resources that you can use. There's a link in the description to the time zone index values from Microsoft. Also, I'll send you a link to this blog post about Microsoft Flow and time zones and formatting. Also, be sure to check out the Microsoft Flow documentation. Definitely check out the Microsoft Flow community, and also check out the Microsoft PowerApps community, both from Microsoft. They have some really great resources there. Definitely check out the PowerApps user group site and the Flow user group site. You can find locals in your area to meet and connect. So that's the end of this series, the Time Zone Converter series. I'll be posting the finished app in the community forum. Check out there if you want to download the app and play around with it. If you have any questions, you can find me on Twitter at @JWillisRose, also on LinkedIn. And of course, you can leave comments below the video. Please like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. Until next time, thank you.